The density of niobium metal will be calculated in this problem, density in grams per cubic centimeter. This is a body center cubic structure. This is important for doing your calculation. And we're given the atomic radius. So the first thing we want to do is look at what the structure looks like so that we can get the dimensions of the unit cell. Represented here, approximately what the structure looks like, where we're drawing an atom on each center corner of a cube. And then this atom here is at the far end of the cube. And then in the center of the cube is an atom which I'll make solid. And of course, this is a representation where in reality, these atoms, this atom, center atom, touches this corner atom and this corner atom. And we'll use the notation that the dimension of unit cell from center of atom to center of atom is A. So A is the unit cell length. We'll use R as the atomic radius and A as the unit cell length. Now we need additional information. We want to calculate A. We're also going to need the atomic mass. And so from a periodic table, atomic mass and niobium, 92.9 grams per mole. So what we want to do is calculate dimensions from R, calculate A. And so what I'm going to look at is these three atoms are diagonal. This atom, atom 1, atom 2, and the center atom are actually touching if I could draw a structure to scale and a space-filling structure. So let me just represent those three atoms. So atom 1, the center atom, atom 2. This is the center. This distance is 4R because R, 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 and R. So we know the dimensions because we know that 4R is 4 times 0.145 nanometers. And what we want to do from geometry, if we know that dimension, calculate the dimension of A. So we're just going to use Pythagorean theorem to do the calculation. So I've drawn a right triangle where 4R is this diagonal dimension, A is the unit cell dimension, and H then is this dimension. So the right triangle, this side, dimension A, this diagonal across the structure, 4R, and this diagonal, which I've called H, and which we don't know yet. And so we then look at another triangle, A, and H, the bottom face of our unit cell. And I've just written Pythagorean theorem because this is a right angle in a unit cell. A squared plus A squared is H squared. So 2A squared equals H squared. And then I can write corresponding A squared plus H squared is equal to 4R squared. A squared. H squared is 2A squared, and that is 16R squared. So 3A squared is 16R squared. So if we move down here, 3A squared is 16R squared. So A squared is 16R squared over 3, which means we know A in terms of R, and we're given R, the atomic radius, so 4 times 0.145 nanometers over the square root of 3 is equal to, so we now have the unit cell dimension, so we can calculate the volume. Since it's a cube, it's just A cubed, so this dimension cubed. So we have the volume, and in a cube, in the body center cubic structure, we have two atoms per unit cell. And if we go back to look at the structure, the center atom is one atom. Each of the corner atoms is shared with seven other unit cells. So this atom has a unit cell here, here, out from the screen, and then above it, four unit cells. So only 1/8 of each of these atoms is in this unit cell. And so this number 2 results because we have one center atom and we have 8 corner atoms, each of which contributes 1/8. So this is the two atoms. And so now we have all the information to calculate the density. Density is the mass of two atoms divided by the volume of the unit cell. And this here is the unit cell volume. So I've substituted the numbers in. Two atoms, the atomic weight 92.9 grams per mole. We don't have a mole of atoms, we only have two atoms. 6.023 atoms per mole. So this now one atom, this is the second atom. Here's the volume. This is nanometers cubed, so 10 to the 7th nanometers is a centimeter, 10 to the 9th nanometers is a meter. And then I cube that, so now I can just do the math and look at the units to see that I'm going to end up with grams per cubic centimeter. And the density I get, 8.204 grams per cubic centimeter, probably 8.2. grams per cubic centimeter. And then we can do a rough check. Does this seem reasonable? We certainly expect it to be higher than 1 gram per cubic centimeter, since that's the density of water and the metals are much more dense. And value of 8 seems a reasonable ballpark. If we then check in the literature, this indeed seems like a reasonable value.